Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome to Grace. My name is Scott Painter, and I serve as the vicar of the community that calls this space home, Grace Episcopal Church in Houston. And it's a joy to welcome everyone together for our online gathering and worship. Especially if you're visiting with us for the first or second time, we extend a hearty welcome to you. And we invite you to find in the comments that run alongside this video a link to our online visitor card. You can click that, let us know that you were with us, and share some basic contact information. We won't share that contact information with anyone else, but what we will do is we will contact you with it. We hope to get to share more about Grace and to learn more about you and the journey that brought you to worship with us today. We'll look forward to that opportunity. Friends, we're mindful that we have come through, along with our neighbors in the Central Gulf Coast, this difficult time with Hurricane Laura, and many folks are picking up the pieces as we deal with the aftermath of this storm. We lift in our prayers today, especially those who are suffering and who have been impacted, and we'll be asking God to inspire us to serve our neighbors in the coming days. Let's quiet our hearts and prepare to worship on this Sunday morning. Blessed be God, most holy, glorious, and undivided Trinity.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever.
Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Oh,
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord of all power and might, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your name. Increase in us true religion. Nourish us with all goodness and bring forth in us the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Love should be shown without pretending. Hate evil and hold on to what is good. Love each other like the members of your family. Be the best at showing honor to each other. Don't hesitate to be enthusiastic. Be on fire in the Spirit as you serve the Lord. Be happy in your hope. Stand your ground when you're in trouble and devote yourselves to prayer. Contribute to the needs of God's people. Welcome strangers into your home. Bless people who harass you. Bless and don't curse them. Be happy with those who are happy and cry with those who are crying. Consider everyone as equal and don't think that you're better than anyone else. Instead, associate with people who have no status. Don't think that you're so smart. Don't pay back anyone for their evil actions with evil actions, but show respect for what everyone else believes is good. If possible, to the best of your ability, live at peace with all people. Don't try to get revenge for yourselves, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath. It is written, "Revenge belongs to me. I will pay it back," says the Lord. Instead, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he's thirsty, give him a drink. By doing this, you will pile burning coals of fire upon his head. Don't be defeated by evil, but defeat evil with good. Hear the words God is saying to his people.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read the psalm appointed for today in unison, Psalm 26. Give judgment for me, O Lord, for I have lived with integrity. I have trusted in the Lord and have not faltered. Test me, O Lord, and try me. Examine my heart and my mind. For your love is before my eyes. I have walked faithfully with you. I have not sat with the worthless, nor do I consort with the deceitful. I have hated the company of evildoers. I will not sit down with wicked. I will wash my hands in innocence, O Lord, that I may go in procession around your altar, singing aloud a song of thanksgiving and recounting all your wonderful deeds. Lord, I love the house in which you dwell and the place where your glory abides.
Resplandecerá y el mundo. Gospel of our Savior Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
From that time, Jesus began to show his disciples that he had to go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders, chief priests, and legal experts, and that he had to be killed and raised on the third day. Then Peter took hold of Jesus and, scolding him, began to correct him. God forbid, Lord, this won't happen to you. But he turned to Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stone that could make me stumble, for you're not thinking God's thoughts, but human thoughts." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "All who want to come after me must say no to themselves, take up their cross, and follow me. All who want to save their lives will lose them. But all who lose their lives because of me will find them. Why would people gain the whole world but lose their lives? What will people give in exchange for their lives? For the human one is about to come with the majesty of his Father with his angels, and then he will repay each one for what that person has done. I assure you that some standing here won't die before they see the human one coming in his kingdom." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Ubuntu. Ubuntu. A Southern African word for humanness or interconnectedness. It is often interpreted and explained to mean we find our own humanity through our relationships with others. A person is a person through other persons. Ubuntu was at the heart of the work for truth and reconciliation in South Africa, led by Archbishop Desmond Tutu and President Nelson Mandela. As that country officially ended and began to dismantle its political and economic systems of racial division, injustice, and subjugation known as apartheid. This was in the 1990s. The spirit of Ubuntu summoned white and black people who had previously been kept starkly separated from one another by the apartheid system, brought them into relationship. Archbishop Tutu preached that all people had been kept from realizing their humanity, from true moral goodness and flourishing, in denying and abstaining from interconnectedness with others. Archbishop Tutu did not advocate a cheap and easy path to pseudo-reconciliation that required no repentance, no restitution from oppressors who benefited from generations of exploitation and domination, but he did lift up the spiritual and relational imperative of Ubuntu. This imperative that he believed must serve as the basis for any true and lasting reconciliation, no matter what political, economic, or cultural reforms would also be required. A person is a person through other persons. Tutu has continued to propose and promote this view of human interdependence and interconnectedness over the last 30 years. He once wrote these words, "We are different so that we can know our need of one another, for no one is ultimately self-sufficient. The completely self-sufficient person would be subhuman." For sure, it is a different way of thinking, believing, and being to our minds shaped by Western philosophy and ideology. So much of what is instilled in us is the idea of the supremacy of the individual, individual rights over any duty to others, individual self-sufficiency over any hope of help from others. In his letter to the Romans, St. Paul's words that we hear today are replete with relationship language, with interconnectedness language. His words convey God calling us forth into relationship with our siblings in the human family. Just reflect with me for a minute over all we hear in these 22 short verses of Romans chapter 12. Love should be shown without pretending. Love each other like members of your own family. Be the best at showing honor to each other. Contribute to the needs of God's people. Welcome strangers into your home. Bless people who harass you. Bless and don't curse them. Be happy with those who are happy and cry with those who are crying. Consider everyone as equal and don't think that you're better than anyone else. Associate with people who have no status. Don't pay back anyone for their evil actions with evil actions. Show respect for what everyone else believes is good. Respect for the common good. Live at peace with all people. And don't try to get revenge for yourselves. All of these exhortations about how to live in relationship with each other are framed for us today by words about differentiating between what is evil and what is good. At the beginning of our passage, we hear these words, hate evil and hold on to what is good. And the final words in our passage, don't be defeated by evil, but defeat evil with good. As I speak to you this morning, I expect that many of you, like me, are emotionally and spiritually burdened, exhausted even, with the great tumult that is plaguing this country in the present moment. Pandemic, police brutality, racial injustice, violence, destruction, unemployment and underemployment. Hyper-partisan division, rapidly growing economic disparity, fear and loneliness, hate and rage, violence and death. I wonder this morning what it would mean for us if we were to relate a little more deeply with the Christians in second century Rome who were receiving these words for the first time in a letter from their pastor, Paul. The Christians there and then, huddled in apartments in a city under powers hostile to their faith. And Paul's words come to them and to us where we are today. Don't be defeated by evil, but defeat evil with good. And what is the good we can do? What is the good we can do? Live the spirit of Ubuntu. Heed the words that come to us in the letter to the Romans. The good we can do is live in love without pretending. Live our lives in a way that is faithful to the way of Jesus, no matter how counter to the prevailing culture and loud voices that may be. Live our lives in such a way as to nurture our interconnectedness with one another. Nurture your interconnectedness with one another. Share what we have together. Welcome and understand strangers. Repay evil with good. Honor the dignity of every human being of equal value and worth as yourself. And to seek to live at peace with all people. Just hearing these words helps us to see how the gospel can be an antidote to what ails us in this world. Don't be defeated by evil, but defeat evil with good. Be a person who is a person through other persons, interconnected, committed to the well-being of others, open to the help and encouragement that is offered to you. Open to the help and encouragement that is offered to you. Committed to true and lasting peace. Maybe this is getting closer to the words of Jesus to his disciples this morning when he says, "All who want to come after me must say no to themselves, take up their cross and follow me. Take up their cross and follow me. All who want to save their lives will lose them, but all who lose their lives because of me will find them." It's not about hating myself or hurting myself. It's not about hating yourself or hurting yourself. Quite the opposite. It's about being so committed to the mission of pursuing the good and well-being of others that my own instincts for self-preservation and promotion and profit diminish. Being transformed little by little into a person who lives more for the good of you than for the good of me. That's a different way of living in this world. This is the teaching we receive in Ubuntu. This is the teaching we see in Paul's letter to the Romans. This is the example and the call we receive from our Lord and Savior. So may these words today take root in our hearts, show evidence in our being and in our acting. May God's Spirit make us more like Jesus. Amen. Let us affirm our faith, saying together the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ, you promise to hear us when we pray to you in faith with thanksgiving. We pray for one another, for our families and friends, through whom we learn to love and to be loved. Thank you for all who care for us. Give us grace to serve Christ by serving our neighbors and our community, loving others as he loves us. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for the unfailing love you hold out to everyone in Jesus Christ. Comfort and heal those in sorrow, need, sickness, or any other trouble. Give them courage and hope in their distress, and bless those who minister to them. We pray especially for Cheryl, Alex, Lindsay, Penny, Nancy, Vion, Mary, Lou, Dan, Fred, Marlene, Mark, Stephanie, Jason, Jillian, Adam, Emily, Marty, Pauline, Louis, Avril, for those impacted by Hurricane Laura, and those we now name. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We remember with gratitude your many gifts to us in creation. Help us and people everywhere to share with justice and peace the resources of the earth. Give wisdom to those in authority among us and to all leaders of the nations. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We pray for your church throughout the world, thanking you for all who serve Christ and the kingdom. By your Spirit, strengthen your people for their work and witness in the world. Unite us in your truth and love, that we who confess your name may also reflect your glory. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We remember with thanksgiving all who have died in Christ, especially Brent, Lisa, Roslyn, Yvonne, and those whom we name. We rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may enter with them into the unending joy of your heavenly kingdom. Merciful God, you look with compassion on those who turn to you. Hear the prayers of your people.
Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Now to God, who is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or conceive, by the power which is at work among us, be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all ages. Amen. Well, once again, good morning, everyone. Welcome to Grace. My name is Scott Painter, and I serve as the vicar of this congregation. It's a special joy to welcome everyone together, especially those who might be joining us for the first or second time. Let me extend a special welcome to you and invite you to find in the links that are found in the comments with this video a link to our online visitor card. If you'll fill that out with some basic information, let us know that you were here today. It'll afford us the opportunity to reach out to you in the coming week to learn more about you and your story, and hopefully to share more about this wonderful community called Grace. Once again, thank you for joining us today. Friends, next Sunday, we will be praying a prayer of blessing for all those who have or will be returning to school in the week to come. Our schools are starting at different times this year as different districts and private schools respond to the dynamics of the coronavirus pandemic, but we are trying to find the sweet spot, a Sunday in the midst of all of those reopenings. We want to pray a special prayer of protection on our teachers and our children, and a blessing for them as they seek to learn under what is going to prove to be difficult situations for many, if not all. So I hope that you'll plan to gather next week. And if you have children in your home who will have a connection with Grace, I hope you'll invite them to join with us so that we might pray for them and celebrate with them the beginning of a new school year. Friends, I also have some sad news to share today. Ellis Montes, who has been our music director for the last 2.5 years, has submitted his resignation from that position, and Ellis will be concluding his ministry with us next Sunday, September 6th. Ellis, we want to thank you for your wonderful ministry among us. You've brought joy and creativity, humility, a loving spirit, excellent musicianship, and so much more. We will miss your presence among us immensely. Friends, I want to invite you to contribute to a special purse that we'll be collecting to bless Ellis as he goes on his way. You can go to our online giving portal at graceinhouston.org/giving. You can select the other category for your gift and write in the memo line the word purse. Then select the amount that you want to give and submit it, and we will collect those funds and gather them up into an offering for Ellis as an expression of our thanks, our appreciation, and our respect. Anyone who wishes to send their offering into the church by mail, you certainly may do so, and we'll do the same with those funds. We'll gather them up and see to it that they get to Ellis. We'll have special presentation in our online video next week to celebrate Ellis's ministry with us, express our gratitude. And so now, friends, let's continue in worship. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
May you go, I'll go, and you stay, I'll stay.
Be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray as Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which passes understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you this day and remain with you forever. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Demos gracias a Dios.
Just a closer one.